Hi, I'm Alicia, and today we're going to learn how to add a background image to the WordPress header and menus. As you may know, you can add background images behind blocks, posts, and pages. But what about specific areas like the header and menus? That's our goal in this video. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Well, let's get started. Setting a background image for the header adds a new vibe to your site, especially if there's a holiday going on or some big sale that you can highlight. To start, go to Appearance, then Header in the WordPress dashboard. You should now see a preview of your homepage on the right side of the screen, along with the header settings to the left side of that. The header module explains the preferred dimensions for any header background image, so you can opt to crop down your image before you upload or wait until you get the image on your WordPress dashboard. Under the current header title, click the Add New Image button. Headers are tricky because you want to ensure that all the links and text elements look crystal clear on top of the background image. Therefore, we recommend testing out background images and considering images that stick to more solid colors and patterns. They won't make it difficult to see your menu items and logo. Select an image that looks ideal for you, then click on the Select and Crop button to proceed. We like the built-in crop tool since it automatically provides the right dimensions for the header background image. This should speed up the process compared to editing a photo beforehand in something like Photoshop. Move the cropping box to the location that makes the most sense for your background image. Feel free to drag one of the corners if you need to cut down the image even more. Once you have the perfect crop, click on the Crop Image button. The header background image gets immediately activated in the WordPress Customizer preview, helping you see exactly what your customers will look at with this type of background. You'll notice that the header background image doesn't bleed over into the rest of the page content. Instead, it remains in the header, behind anything that's currently located there, like a logo, tagline, menu, and search bar. Another option for your header background is to upload several images and have them randomly rotate, adding a bit of flair and surprise to your website whenever a user lands on the homepage. To make this work, you must first have several images uploaded to the header settings box. Click on the Add New Image button to complete the process. Once you have more than one image, click on the Randomize Uploaded Headers button to activate the feature that shows a different header background every time. You may notice that adding a background image to the header makes it difficult to see some of the header items, like your menu or a shopping cart. If that's the case, we suggest refraining from immediately deleting the header image. Instead, go to the Text Color and Link Color fields to see if any adjustments may help. The Text Color setting controls any text in the header that's not hyperlinked to another internal or external page. Many times, that only means the tagline, if you have one, but sometimes you may have other items like a shopping cart, total, or social media icons that also change colors with the text. The other box is for the link color. You'll most likely see more changes when you adjust this color since it includes all menu items linked to your other pages. Here's an example of what happens when you pick a new color for both the text color and the link color. You can see that the tagline and site name changed, the menu changed to white, and so did most of the other header elements like the shopping cart icon. For those not interested in using a background image for your header, you also have the option to use a solid color background. For this, find the background color field under the same header settings area. Click on the Select Color button and choose from the color panel to see the preview results. You can also change the text colors when using a background color. After testing what works best for your header and deciding on the perfect background image for that header, click the Publish button for all to see the changes. If you have any problems rendering the changes in your front end, consider clearing your WordPress cache. You may have noticed some websites with fancy menus that include background images or icons. This is a common practice in the e-commerce world, where the brand may have a mega menu with categories and background images for each category button. If you're interested in adding backgrounds to your menu, look at our article on the best WordPress menu plugins. Many of these menu plugins offer options to include image and color backgrounds within your menu. Seeing as how there are several plugins to add a certain background for navigational menus, we'll provide tutorials for two, one of which allows for backgrounds behind your submenu. In contrast, the other one adds a background to your mobile menu. To add a background image to different submenus, install and activate the WP Mega Menu plugin. This plugin allows you to activate and manage a mega menu with multiple drop-down levels. It's ideal for large online stores, but it does the trick for smaller menus as well, especially if you want to add a background image or icons. Begin by finding the WP Mega Menu tab in the WordPress dashboard. Click on the Themes menu item. Here, you can see a list of default themes created for your menu by the plugin. You can click to edit any of these themes or add your own design from scratch. Each theme has its own settings where you specify elements like the theme title, menu bar options, and the brand logo. Just about every part of your menu is customizable, from the drop-down menu to the submenus. However, for the menu background, you simply need to know which theme you want to choose. Go to Appearance, then Menus in the dashboard. You'll see a new module that links to the Mega Menu settings. Click to enable the Mega Menu, then choose whichever of them you like the best for your website. Finally, click the Save button. Now, shift your attention to the menu structure area. Scrolling over any of your current menu items reveals a WP Mega Menu button. This is where you customize the layout and design for each drop-down section. Click the WP Mega Menu button for any menu item you want. For this case, we'll add a drop-down Mega Menu to the Shop tab. In the new pop-up window, flip the switch to turn on the Mega Menu for that particular menu item. You can then add a drop-down row and drag some of the mini widgets from the left side into that row. For instance, we'll drag a list of products so that they show up when someone scrolls over the Shop menu item. To add a background to this drop-down area, click the Options button in the lower left-hand corner. Find the Upload Background Image field. Click the Upload button to find the right photo in your media library to use it as the background. An image thumbnail appears after you select it from the media library. There are some other settings to consider, so feel free to check on those if you want. Be sure to click on the Save Changes button at the bottom of the Options panel. You'll also need to click on Save Menu back in the menu structure area of the WordPress dashboard. Now, navigate to the front end of your website to see the menu. If you scroll over the item we just customized, you should see a drop-down section with the background. Another way to add a background image to a menu is by using a mobile responsive menu that shows up when someone accesses your website through a mobile device. You can place a background behind the mobile menu with the help of WP Mobile Menu plugin. After installing and activating the WP Mobile Menu plugin, go to Mobile Menu Options in the WordPress dashboard. The plugin offers several ways to configure your mobile menu. The general requirement is to enable one of the menu formats and indicate which WordPress menu you want to use for that mobile menu. For example, we can click on the Enable Left Menu switch, turning on a mobile menu that sits on the left side of the screen, and choose the Main Menu option from the Left Menu dropdown. This links our current main menu with the mobile menu so visitors see the same tabs. It depends on the type of mobile menu you create, but since we're making a left side menu, we can click on the Left Menu tab to reveal the appropriate settings to add a background. Scroll down to the Panel Background Image field and click the plus sign to open the media library. Select an image from your media library and add it to the field. You should see a thumbnail version of the background image as confirmation. Select the Save Changes button to activate the background. Seeing as how the plugin generates mobile menus, the menu may only show up when your browser is set at a narrow width or when you go to your site on a phone or tablet. The new menu gets consolidated under a hamburger icon. Click that to test the new menu with the background. As shown in the screenshot, the background gets placed behind the entire mobile menu for everyone to see. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.